emotional.
Helvete.
Yes. Hi. What the fuck?
Hi.
Yeah, it was such a night.
Thank you so much for coming here.
Yeah. Thank you so much to you guys for being here on this night. You know, it means a lot to the people that are here. I'm going to let you breathe
Thanks.
A little bit because we have someone who is actually not here, unfortunately, and that is Malte. But he has sent a video, so he will
really?
Start the Whoa. Q&A for us. So
I'm such a big fan.
Let's roll.
Let's see, let's see.
Jag har inte ord att beskriva hur sorgligt det känns att inte kunna vara med idag. Men jag tycker att det är underbart att så många av er har kommit hit och hoppas ni gillar det här, allt vi har gjort. Och jag vill bara tacka alla för att ni har följt med oss den här långa vägen. Och för att på något sätt känna att jag är delaktig på något sätt, så vill jag ändå kickstarta Q&A. Så jag gör det nu. Och jag börjar med att fråga Edvin. Om du fick spela vilken annan roll som helst, vilken skulle du välja?
Tough question.
Okay, man.
Now you also know the end, like, so now you can
yeah.
say, yeah.
It used to be easier, because I used to reply with August, actually. I think he's one of the best characters of the whole show. But now, he has a very sad ending, I think. It's kind of hard, actually. No, I would like to play Boris, actually, next time. Is that a thumbs up from you, Klaus? Okay, yes.
Maybe.
Perfect.
Have any of you other guys thought about, like, if I should have played someone else, who would have that been? Would that have been?
I think I would want to play Nils.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
He's a fun guy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The girls?
I think either Nils or Rousseau.
okay. Yeah.
I would say August.
Yeah.
Just because he's such an amazing written character.
Yeah.
His arc from season one to season three is amazing. And that's because of that person over there.
And Malte. Yeah. Let's give it up for Malte.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, well, obviously this is such a special night. We see on your tears that it's, I mean, you have seen now the final episode. It is out, which means like it's for the world to see, but it's also an ending for you guys. So I see that there are some tears, which is probably also because of the documentary, I guess.
Yeah.
I mean, that's to see your peers. But can you describe any feelings? Like, how does it feel now? Because it's over in some sense, or in every sense almost.
Stop.
In every sense.
Sorry, but I mean, I'm not Boris, but I have to, you know, give you the facts.
No, it feels so surreal. I can't look any of you in the eye. It's just, we're so lucky because we're practically the only show that's ever been made here in Sweden that has like a fandom.
Like this.
Yeah. And, and this show would not be what it is today without you guys. We love you.
We love you.
And it's just like, there's so many emotions going on. I'm like rambling, but like, I'm going to miss this like connection with you guys. We're still here. But also like with our fellow castmates sitting over there, like not being able to, oh my God.
Yeah.
Can you continue?
No, I can't.
You have to look at me then, so you know.
Yeah. To not have the amazing privilege to work with these amazing people every day, I'm going to miss that a lot.
But I hope you're also grateful, because this is like...
No!
No.
I'm kidding.
It's such like, that will also be part of the emotions, I hope, that you have been able to do this. It's such an amazing show, and as you say, with the fans and everyone you work with. So I hope that that's also like...
Yeah,
and also we're so lucky that we actually got to do 3 seasons.
Yeah.
And that we're actually here today. Like, that would never happen if we would just do one.
You know?
And we weren't sure if we would do like multiple seasons.
No.
So like to be here today, like 3 years later, like it's just a huge, it's such a huge deal. You know,
it's an honor.
It's an honor.
Yeah. And we're
privilege.
How you usually say, like, we shouldn't be sad that it's.
Oh yeah, yeah. Don't.
Yeah, you said that.
Don't cry because it no.
Oh my God!
Don't cry because it's
flopped.
Over. Smile because it happened.
Yeah.
Yeah. It takes me a little bit to the next question, actually, because Edvin, you said somehow that Omar, you thought it was going to be really big from the beginning. You were like, you thought.
I didn't.
And now you
thought,
say
I
three.
Knew.
You knew.
I knew.
Yeah.
I knew.
What about you girls? Because
no.
I mean.
I did not. I mean, well, it was Netflix, so I thought it was going to be big, but I didn't know, like, the reach of it.
Yeah.
It's amazing.
Yeah.
I mean, just to be in here, I've heard numbers about 60,000 people took the exam to be in this room, which is a lot of people. So you're very privileged, you guys that are here, I have to say.
Yeah, and applause to you guys.
Good job, guys. Yeah. Good job.
And on FaceTime.
And I'm not sure, but I have heard rumors that there are people from like all over the world that are here. People from Australia, from like, yeah. And I mean, that does not happen like that. You have had such an impact.
Imagine the amount of jet lag in this room right
now.
Yes.
There are people from Australia here, right? Yes.
Down under.
That is dedication. That is amazing. But I mean, so when did you then realize how big it was going to become? Was it after it was released, or did you along the way also feel like, oh God, I think this is going to really hit with the audience?
For me, it was when we were in Copenhagen, actually. Because we were doing like Copenhagen Fashion Week.
Okay.
Ooh. And
The guys are like, ooh, okay.
I just throw that out.
Really? Yeah. Copenhagen?
No, but it was so weird because we were at a restaurant and it was like during COVID or at the end of COVID. So we could just started traveling and two girls just like stopped right in front of us and then turned to us with like my Instagram, I think, and was like...
Yeah, they saw you first. And I had my back turned to them, so I looked back, and they were like, oh my God, it's another one! There's two of them!
I think that was the first time I realized,
that was
like,
crazy.
People from outside of Sweden see this.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
Yeah, I think that's something that impresses Swedes, when you feel like it's outside of Sweden.
I know.
Yeah. Well, oh, wow. I mean, you can be big in Sweden, but when you're somewhere else, Brazil, oh, my God, then you're really big. Yeah. How was it for you? When did you realize?
I don't know. I think I kind of realized when, like, we were about to start season two, I think. Mm-hmm. Like, a few months later, after we, like, had all these experiences like through those months, like the half year, that's kind of when you started to realize that, you know, like people actually care about the second season. And it was just like a lot of, it was hectic, very hectic on social media, and we met like a lot of people and a lot of fans like when we traveled and stuff like that. And I don't know, it like took some time because you see numbers on your phone. Because we saw numbers like the day it dropped. And we were like, oh shit. But then, like, when, like, weeks and months passed, you kind of just realized, oh, my gosh, this is actually, like, real people.
Yeah.
And look at this. Like, it's just, like, a crowd of people here. And it's just, this is when you actually understand, like, how big it actually is.
Yeah.
You
know? But it's, I mean, it's entertaining as well, of course. But then I think, or maybe you can correct me here, but then, like, it also became important for causes. You know what I mean? Like, it has such an importance for people all over the world. Yeah. Was that also the initial, what your initial response? Or did that also grow through time where you felt like, okay, what we're doing is not just, you know, entertaining an audience. It's also so important for the people watching.
I think it's, like, still growing Yeah. Honestly, like this family right here, it's never ending and it's always growing and it's beautiful. And I think we've had a few moments like during the course of the time. Like I heard someone at the university here in Stockholm was like doing a study about this fandom, and
what?
I was like, "What? Yeah,
really?
Sign up, yeah. guys."
Yeah, because yeah, everybody's so fascinated about it that it actually like resonated with people for real, and like yeah. the messages we've received. I just remembered today actually when I got a letter, a handwritten letter from a Dutch baron, mm-hmm. Who was like, yeah, this show is about me, which was super powerful. He was like, yeah, when I grew up I came from the same like traditions and nobility and stuff, and I couldn't love whoever I wanted to, but now I can, and like this means so much to us. And
yeah,
those kinds of stories that we've been told have been mind-blowing. It's been amazing.
Yeah, I mean, as you can see, a lot of people are here and they wanted to come, and an amount of streamers that are live streamers that are watching
oh, yeah.
right now. We have actually told them, yeah, you can wave to them. Yeah. I think it's the red
yes.
camera over there. They have left some questions as well. So I'm going to actually go and say some of the
Ooh.
Questions that comes from them. So right. now, prepare yourself. It's going to be you as well. Let's start with the live streamers.
Okay.
The first question was, does any of you have a favorite outfit of yours that you have worn during the
yes.
show?
I do. I wore it for one scene. Mm-hmm. It was dope. Like there was these like beautiful green, like bootcut acne pants, and there was this like red suede like jacket, and I had the glasses.
Good for you.
I
good
felt
for
good.
You.
Yeah.
good
for you.
Yeah. They realized like, oh, he's too pretty. We gotta like. I okay. swear that's what happened.
Yeah,
I
yeah.
swear.
Okay, now you have to yeah. like go up for the rest of the gang, Frida.
the uniform.
Oh yeah.
Obviously.
Yeah. Obviously.
Gorgeous.
I actually don't. Well. Maybe. Which one were you thinking on?
You had so many hot
I know,
outfits.
But yeah. that's why it's so hard.
Yeah.
But I think like the dress from the white party was a good
oh,
one.
Oh yeah.
That was
yeah,
cute.
That's really
that
nice.
Was cute.
and I have a follow-up question for you as well. You can start.
I kind of agree with Frida. Like the uniform was good looking, but then I would just say, you know, the purple hoodie. Yep.
I didn't know this, but we got a question from the streamer, and they asked, why did Simon wear a pyjamas to Ville's birthday?
Well, who's in charge?
Yeah.
Up on stage? No, I literally don't have a clue. I don't know. It was not pyjama pants. Like, they were like normal pants.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But they were looking like pajama pants, and I don't know why.
It wasn't your decision, then.
Definitely
no,
not.
No, you're more fashion than that. Okay.
It's in fashion, though.
Yeah.
Like I see a lot of like 16-year-olds wear those pants,
yeah.
those kind of pants. I see someone pointing down. The yeah.
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 Oh,
come
you
on.
Have them on?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
damn.
Yeah.
yeah.
See?
Yeah.
It's fashion.
It's fashion. Look it up. Yeah.
Make it fashion.
And then we have a second question.
Okay.
And this is also. That I don't really know, but I'm also interested to know what happened to the principal.
Anette. yeah. No, so story-wise, she was removed pretty instantly when these news about the school and the initiation process, all of that stuff surfaced. She was unfortunately removed from her position. Free Anette. she's in jail somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
With Rousseau.
With Rousseau.
And the fishes.
Yes, yeah. yeah.
Well, we also have asked people here
Ooh.
To write in some, so I'm going to just think, I'm going to see what might be here.
Okay.
Exciting.
Oh, well, there was actually someone else saying, why is Simon wearing pajamas?
Oh, yeah.
oh.
Maybe
mind-blowing that he would wear
oh,
pajamas.
Here is one. Can you tell us any, if there was any of your favorite scenes that was actually deleted from the final show?
From the final?
From this season?
No, I think you can go all over seasons, I guess. Ooh. But anything that you wanted to have still, but
of course we can. It's not spoilers.
Okay.
No. Or maybe
I'm just saying. Yeah,
yeah. Yeah.
I mean, if you're on the live stream, you have to have watched it.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
That's okay, up to them. Yeah.
They cut one scene when Feliz got to scream a bit.
Yeah. I love that scene. That was the one on her.
Sarah. Oh. No, not me, Sarah.
Yeah, Sarah. Sarah.
I really like that scene.
Me too.
Because she's always been so well put together.
Yeah. And I just got to scream it out, and I was crying, and I loved
really
it.
Nice.
It was very pure, fine. Briga cut. But I think it was for the best, though. So.
Yeah. I actually have a funny story. I don't remember all of the deleted scenes from like the first and second season, because like it's just so hard to remember. But you know the scene where Simon, when they're striking and Simon walks in with a lollipop?
Oh, yeah.
This was actually very funny because in the series, Simon and Wilhelm would share the lollipop. And so I had like, I was sitting like this and I had a little like glass between my legs. Yeah. And I had another lollipop in the glass. And I was supposed to like in the scene, suck on the lollipop. And then like casually just taking it down and pulling the other lollipop up because he didn't want to share with me in real life. So
you had a cold, man.
Yeah, I had a cold. I kind of had a cold, yeah.
Yeah.
But and then I took the other lollipop, and that's the one that I gave you, like. Yeah. And so we had to fake that, but that got too like complicated, and so that got deleted. But they were sharing the lollipop, and what's the name of
Henry?
Yes, Henry.
Yes.
He was like. Like us sharing the lollipop, and it was very funny, but then it got deleted. So but it was very funny. Like.
Yeah, I wish I could remember any scenes from season one or two right now, but I don't. But there was this one scene. The sweater?
When he forgets the sweater in season two?
The orange sweater? I don't know what you're talking about. there was this one scene for the last season. It's the end of episode four, three, Jerry? Bryggan, you know? Yeah? Episode four? Yeah. Episode four, I had this amazing scene with Samuel. I love you, man. where we were like talking by this little, there's this paddle tennis court by the water. We were it was beautiful. Yeah.
Yeah.
I always hate when our scenes get deleted. Yeah.
What were you talking about?
Erik being at the initiation. Oh. Yeah. So it was kind of,
kind of
a bummer.
And Sara and Wilhelm finally got a line in season three. They finally talked.
Yeah.
But we tried to have a line in season two that got
cut. They cut
at the
that
shooting
out.
Range
Which
when
one?
He says,
"We've been trying to interact for like three seasons."
Yeah, we finally got it.
That's why we were like cheering as crazy when that scene came up. But there was this one scene in season two at the shooting range where I don't remember the lines.
Sara says, "It was me. I told him," and you say, "Why?" I don't understand why they cut that. Why, Sara? Why?
Yeah. Well, speaking of scenes, I guess there are some scenes, but there are that you are a little bit more mad with your own character. I mean, you have to be frustrated with how your character acts sometimes, right? All of you? No.
Yeah. No, Feliz is perfect.
Feliz is perfect. So, okay, so this is not a question for you, Nikita, but for the rest of you, what scenes do you remember where you felt like, ugh, this my character is just behaving like such a.
Yes, the tent scene. But it was a nice homage to Anette, actually. You don't hush people like that. That's rude.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
No, I don't know.
No.
No, nothing. No.
Also good all the time.
Yeah. No, like every choice in season two. I think. I think.
Yeah. Omar? You got the approval there.
Well, I don't know. I cannot. Nothing. Yes,
they will Marcus? Call you out. You know, so
Marcus.
You might.
They're screaming Marcus.
Marcus. I love Marcus.
So that was a trigger.
Yeah. Don't say the M word in here.
Don't say the M word. Yeah. Don't
say the M word. Well, so of course you've been frustrated with your characters as well, but there must be some scenes as well. This is also a question from someone in here, which is like, what kind of favorites? What was your favorite scene to do, or that you that you have seen afterwards? Because there's one thing to do them, but it's the other thing to see them.
I actually really love, like, watching back at the scene between me and Malte here in the end of episode 6 at the party. Yeah. I thought that was so beautiful, like, their arc actually coming to a close and being able to, like, understand each other. That was really beautiful. But, like, my favorite to shoot was probably the football field scene from season 1.
Yeah. You can go crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
What about Omar?
I mean, I have this one scene that kind of marked my heart a little, and that's probably the lake scene that we did.
Yeah.
And that is because it was such an special day, because it was the last day, and we did the last scene with you guys right before that in the car and all of that. And yeah, I don't know, that day was just so beautiful, and shooting at the lake was just so beautiful.
Yeah.
And just like emotional and all of that. So I loved that. Even though the water was so freaking cold. It was so cold.
Yeah.
It is Sweden after
and
all.
And then after, when I got to warm up, they told me, you got to jump in the water again.
Yeah.
And that was horrible. But it was
turned out beautiful.
Yeah. It was very special.
Yeah.
Do you have any?
I think for me, it was the scene where all of the girls, except Sarah, was in Felice's room. And they were talking about the initiations and everything. And Felice finally tries to, like, talk to the girls about her heritage and the hair and everything. Mm. I feel like that marked something in me. It wasn't, like, the funniest scene to, like, shoot, but it was so important to me personally.
Yeah.
And I wanted to do it justice. Yeah. And I remember talking so much to Lisa about it, because it was such a, like, key moment for Felice. So I would say that one.
That is one of my favorite scenes also, actually.
And the awkward silence makes it so much better.
I yeah, like. That's
like
so
like when everyone's
good.
Quiet and she's
so
like,
beautiful.
Beautiful.
Yeah, that's funny.
I liked in episode 5 when Sarah finally breaks down, because the whole season she's just been all keeping everything inside of her. It was really nice for me as a private person also to ugly cry like that. It was really nice. And to have that moment with Simon.
Yeah, that one is
finally.
So beautiful, yeah. You're like, I took the driving license. Like so sad, but still like, yeah, it was very funny. Very beautiful.
Funny.
Beautiful too. Like just yeah. It was beautiful. I love that scene.
Yeah.
Good job.
Thank you.
Plenty of amazing scenes, of course. Yeah, you can applaud whenever you want, guys. These guys, the Fantastic Four, they deserve applause in between. I mean, we're running a little bit out of time, I think. I mean, I understand you want to listen even more, but I thought that this is quite a nice opportunity for you guys. I mean, both Omar and Edvin, you said, like, thank you a little bit in the video, but I mean, you have the hardcore fans that are here. Yeah. Is there anything, I mean, you also said thank you, but is there maybe anything else you want to say? I mean, maybe Frida, Nikki?
I want to say thank you so much.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's been, I'm going to start crying, and it's okay, because emotion is good. But honestly, I'm so grateful for you guys. You're the heart and core that keeps it, like, running. And this wouldn't be possible without you, obviously, so thank you so, so much for being the people that you are. And I see your group chats out there that you put us in. I can't answer them, but sometimes I go in and read them, and I feel like you're such a lovely people to each other as well, all over the world. So I just want to say thank you so much for that and taking care of each other. It's a hard world that we're living in, and I'm just so thankful and glad to see that you have each other. And yeah, love you guys.